Welcome back to my channel JBR Online Classes. Like, share and subscribe my channel. Hello everyone, so today I'm going to start exercise 10.4 from sum number 7. For the previous sum, please check the description box, the link will be there. Or you can also visit our website to get the chapter wise solution. So here in sum number 7, in the adjoining figure AD bisects angle A. Arrange AB, BD and DC in the descending order of their length. So as here angle B equal to 60 degree, angle C equal to 40 degree, then definitely the rest angle will be 80 degree, because the sum of three angles that equal to 180. So here if angle A equal to 80 degree, then the and AD as the bisector, then these two angle equal to 40 and 40. I hope it's clear. Now in triangle ABD, okay, in triangle ABD, if this one 60, this one 40, so it becomes 100, then again this one equal to 80 degree. Okay, so now you know that the opposite side of the greater angle will be always greater. Okay, so that means here AB greater than, AB greater than, here 40 degree the smallest angle, so the opposite side BD, so definitely AB greater than BD. Okay, definitely here AD greater than BD. Now here in this triangle, okay, so here in this triangle, here this one 40, this one 40, so definitely this one will be 100. So now here this is the this angle is the opposite of 40 degree, this side is the opposite of 40 degree, so definitely here AD equal to DC. Okay, and here also the opposite side of 40 degree equal to BD, so it's clearly that the 80 degree is greater than 40 and this 40 also. Okay, so you can write down here angle ADB is greater than angle DAC. DAC that means 40 degree, and which is equal to angle BAD, because BAD is also 40 degree. So hence here AB, DC and then BD in the descending order of their length. Okay, AB, DC and BD are in the descending order of their length. Or you can also write that AB, DC and BD in their descending order, because here DC equal to BD. So now sum number 8A. In sum number 8A, here ABD is a triangle, okay, AD and CE are the perpendicular. Okay, so now first you have to prove that here CF greater than AF. So to prove that CF greater than AF, that means the opposite angle CF, that means this one will be greater than the opposite angle AF, that equal to this one. So you have to show that that angle FAC is greater than angle FCA. That means first you have to find out the value of these two angles. So as this one AE, this one 90 degree, this one 60 degree. So in triangle AEC, definitely this one equal to 30 degree, because 90 plus 60, 150. So this one equal to 30. And as same as BEC, in this triangle, this one equal to 90, this one 65. So definitely this one equal to 25 degree. Okay, I hope it's clear. So now as this one equal to 90, this one equal to 25. So definitely the outer one, that means this angle equal to, you know that 115 degree, because 90 plus 25, so this angle equal to 115 degree. Okay. So now as this angle equal to 115, this one equal to 30, then definitely this angle equal to 35 degree. So here
angle FAC equal to 35, which is greater than this angle 30 degree. So definitely you can write here CF greater than AF, because the opposite side of the greatest angle, that equal to greater, and the opposite side of the smallest angle equal to smaller. So CF greater than AF, it's proved. Now next one, sum number 8B. In sum number 8B, here ABD is a triangle and here AC is a line. So AB equal to AC, it given. Okay, so if AB equal to AC, then definitely this angle equal to 70, so this angle equal to also 70. This angle equal to 40 degree, it's given. Now you have to show that AB greater than CD. So if AB greater than CD, that means definitely AC also greater than CD. Okay, CA also greater than CD, because AB equal to CA. So now you have to prove that CA greater than CD. So as here the opposite angle of CA equal to 40 degree, now you have to find out the opposite angle of CD. So you know that here 70 degree is the external angle and the opposite to internal angle, this one equal to 40, then definitely this one equal to 30, because the addition of opposite to internal angles, that equal to external. So 40 plus 30, that equal to 70. So as you know, this one is the opposite side and here this one is the opposite side. So 40 is greater than 30 degree. 40 is greater than 30 degree. Then definitely here AC greater than CD. And AC is equal to with AB. So AB also greater than CD. It's proved. Now sum number 8C. In sum number 8C here, in the given figure below here, AC equal to CD. Okay, very good. Now you have to show that BC less than CD. You have to show that BC, this one, less than CD. So first you have to show that BC less than AC. Okay, first you have to show that BC less than AC, because here AC and CD will be equal. So as here the opposite angle of BC equal to this one and opposite angle of AC equal to this one. So first you have to find out the value of these two angles. So here 70 degree is the external angle of this triangle. You know that the addition of these two angle will be this one. Okay. And as these two sides are equal, that means it is a isosceles triangle. So this angle will be equal to this one. So this one equal to 35 and this one equal to 35, because 35 plus 35, that equal to 70. Okay, I hope it's clear. Now as the whole angle equal to 70 degree, so if the right one equal to 35, then the left one equal to also 35. Okay, and here in triangle ABD, here angle A equal to 70, angle D equal to 35, then definitely this one, this angle will be 75 degree. Okay, because 75, 70 and 35 becomes 185. Now in this triangle ABC, AC is the opposite of 75 degree and BC is the opposite of 35 degree. So as you know, 75 degree is greater than 35 degree, then definitely AC greater than BC. Okay, so if AC greater than BC, that means here CD also greater than BC. So if CD greater than BC, that means the opposite, BC less than CD. It's proved. Now sum number 9A. In the figure, here angle B is less than angle A. Okay, angle B is less than angle A, and angle C is less than angle D. Show that here AD is less than BC. Okay, AD is less than BC. So in the triangle ABO, angle B is less than angle A, that means definitely AO less than BO. Okay, AO less than BO. Now similarly in the angle COD, that means triangle, angle C is less than D, so definitely OD. OD less than OC. So this one your first equation and this one your second equation. Now if you add these two equation, then AO plus OD it becomes AD. AO plus OD it becomes AD. And here BO plus OC it becomes BC. So here AD less than BC it's proved. Next, sum number 9B. In sum number 9B, here in the figure, D is any point on the side BC. In the triangle ABC, if AB greater than AC, AB greater than AC, then show that, you have to show that AB greater than AD also. Okay, so now in the triangle here, AB greater than AC. If AB greater than AC, then definitely angle B, here angle B less than angle C, or you can also write the opposite one, angle C greater than angle B. Okay, it's clear now. So now in the triangle ABD, this one, the left side triangle, in the triangle ABD, this one, the external angle, this one definitely greater than angle B. So you have to write down the exterior angle ADC is greater than angle B. Okay, and you know that angle ADC, this angle ADC is greater than angle C. So you can write down angle ADC is greater than angle C, because as here angle C greater than angle B, then definitely this angle greater than angle B, so angle ADC will be also greater than angle C. Okay, so now AC greater than AD. Okay, AC greater than AD, but here AB greater than AC, but here AB greater than AC, so from this one AC greater than AD, but here AB greater than AC, so from this one you can write down AB greater than AD, and it's proved. Now the last one, sum number 10-1. So guys, if you like my video, please share this video and please subscribe my channel. So here, is it possible to construct a length with the side 4 cm, 3 cm and 7 cm? So as you know that the sum of any two sides will be greater than the third side, but here 4 plus 3 it becomes 7, and which is equal to this one, that means the third side. So that means hence to construct of this triangle is not possible. Now next one, number 2, is it possible to construct a triangle with length of side 9, 7 and 17? So as here 9 plus 7 it becomes 16, and 16 is less than 17, because as you know that 16 is less than 17, so it's very clear. So that means here it is not possible to construct, because the addition of any two sides will be always greater than the third side. Now the last one, it is possible to construct the triangle of length that is 8, 7 and 4. So 8 plus 7 that equal to, you know that equal to 15. So 15 always greater than 4, or if you add 7 plus 4 that equal also 11, 11 is also greater than 8. Okay, that means addition of these two sides will be greater than the third side. So yes, it is possible to construct this triangle.